You are listening to The Voice of the Gospel, a proclamation of the Holy Gospel by Wisdom Ministries.
February 16th, Tuesday. Let's begin this day with the blessings of God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark chapter 8, verses 14 to 21. Now, the disciples had forgotten to bring any bread, and they had only one loaf with them in the boat. And he cautioned them, saying, "Watch out, beware of the yeast of the Pharisees and the yeast of Herod." They said to one another, "It is because we have no bread." And becoming aware of it, Jesus said to them, "Why are you talking about having no bread? Do you still not perceive or understand? Are you hardened? Do you have eyes and fail to see? Do you have ears and fail to hear? And do you not remember when I broke the 5 loaves for the 5,000, how many baskets full of broken pieces did you collect?" They said to him, 12. "And the 7 for the 4,000, how many baskets full of broken pieces did you collect?" And they said to him, 7. Then he said to them, "Do you not yet understand?" The Gospel of the Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. Dear friends, today's Gospel, Jesus is warning his disciples to watch out against the yeast of the Pharisees and the Herod. They do not understand what Jesus meant. Leaven is a piece of dough from leftover bread which has the ability to ferment an entire mass of dough, causing it to grow, multiply and change its very shape and texture. And the use of leaven was strictly forbidden in all offerings made to the Lord by fire. Fermentation is associated with putrefaction or moral corruption. Actually, for the Jews, leaven is a sign of evil that subtly influencing our lives. It is also an image of corruptness and of perverseness and of a hardened life. Jesus wants his disciples to avoid the way of the Pharisees and of Herod, who seek their own counsels rather than the will of God. They are those who oppose Jesus Christ. This can be the meaning of the yeast, of the Pharisees and of Herod. But how can we guard against the leaven of Pharisees and Herod? First is by refusing the evil influence of leaven of others. Second is to understand by remembering. Jesus corrects his disciples by inviting them to remember the miracles he has worked, like the multiplication of loaves. This frees the disciples from their narrow-minded concern for their human error and puts everything into a supernatural perspective. We must not easily forget what God has really done for us and to doubt what he promises to do as well. Do we take time to remember the many good things God has done for us, like the miracles he has done in our lives, so as to put his kingdom first in our lives? Jesus warns us of bad leaven, the leaven of the Pharisees, which is pride, and that of Herod, which is sensuality. And so the third is to permeate the world with the good yeast, or the influence that Christian should exert in his surroundings and make Christ reign in the hearts and minds of all men and women. We must strive to be sincere in our effort to exert a good influence in our surroundings. One upright, honest, holy man can mean a lot. Amen. May God bless.